We were joking around again, sir, and it went too far, just like it always does. Someone always gets hurt. Just like when I almost killed myself when Julie gave me chode jeans.
Wow, right? I mean, goes without saying, and yet here I am saying it. We are so pleased with how this campaign is being received. Right? Bridget, do you care to walk us through some of the rollout details?
So we launched last month across digital, traditional, streaming, and even print. It was a bold strategy, but the numbers are really paying off.
Incredible.
Okay.
That is really exciting
stuff.
I'll take it. That is really exciting stuff. Now, who we're dealing with here, you know, they're a high premium brand. And so success here
is good, sir. We can work with those kind of high-caliber brands.
You know, that's exactly what I was thinking, if I could just jump in for a second. We've had some fantastic calls with Martin's Head, you know, and Tragus Solutions. And if we circle back next week, I think we can close those deals.
And I would add Hodge to that list, too. Hunter and I had a great conversation with them last month, and I want to circle back with them because I think they're really ready to do some business. Thank you, Sonia. I love to know that.
No problem.
And this is going to come as no surprise to all you guys, but it all comes back to the creative. You know, Clint, congrats again on that. I wonder if you want to talk, you know, from a content perspective about how that went down.
We were really working with a great team of creatives who I think totally got the product. Sonia, were you able to connect with the client?
Not since last week, I'm gonna see Kathy at the event on Tuesday. I'm gonna circle around with her to see if they're still ready to engage.
If I could just chime in here. This has no doubt been a success on so many levels, right? But from a sales perspective, I think that we can do better in Q3. What we need to do is increase the money for these types of projects specifically.
I wanna say, it's possible that this deal predates our new sales goals. Or at least when we made them more explicit.
And we can look granular on that on the sales call on Friday.
I'll make a note of that.
Just real quick, Hunter and Hoyt, if you guys can't hear us right now, it's because we're on this end digging into some fabulous nectarines. So tasty, so supple, so fresh. Really, really juicy.
Oh, my God.
Hasn't been an issue here. Hearing you loud and clear.
Thanks, boy. Hunter?
Some situation over here. We've had ourselves immune, so just let us know if our nectarines become a problem.
They haven't. It's been fine.
Okay, great. Now we're all on the same page.
Actually, Hunter, now might be a real good time to get some developments of what's going on your end. So, what's new in Singapore, brother?
We've had some really good meetings out here. I wouldn't say anything is closed, but I would say we're close.
Come on! There it goes.
I think that's enough updates for the afternoon.
I just want to make the first to thank you all for giving your time today.
For our pleasure! Our pleasure!
That's what we're here for.
Elizabeth! Brett! Can we get you out of here?
There we go. Hit me, baby.
Hello.
Hit me!
And that takes care of addendum 4. How's everybody doing?
Great. I think we're really making progress.
Awesome. All right, I got to jump on a call real quick when I get back. We'll get started on addendum 5.
And boss is gone.
Whoa.
Surf's up, dudes.
Paul, what are you doing?
I'm surfing, baby.
Hey, awesome. Hey, Tim, brother.
Yeah, ride the big waves, baby. Woo!
Guys.
Yes, that's what I'm talking about, ladies. Let them go. Feel that breeze, baby.
Come on, guys.
This is so fun.
What's up for the spray? Whoa! I'm digging it. Groovy, Carlos. Very groovy.
I'm a shark. Watch out. Come to get me.
Gnarly, dude. Yes. Check out these whirlpools. Woo! Very creative. Oh, hey, check this out.
Oh, awesome. 360.
Yeah. First break.
Here comes a big wave.
Napkins. Paul, I need napkins.
Can you hear me, honey?
Can somebody move this chair?
I need a wet paper towel.
Russell, you idiot. You could have killed Paul.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Fucking psycho.
What the hell happened here?
Ask Russell.
Russell, what happened?
We were joking around again, sir, and it went too far, just like it always does. Someone always gets hurt. Just like when I almost killed myself when Julie gave me chode jeans.
What?
Like when I turned 45 and I said, no gag gifts, and Julie gave me chode jeans and I almost killed myself.
What are chode jeans?
Chode jeans. They're jeans for a chode. Size 54 waist, 10 inch legs, fucking junk. Julie gave them to me.
It was just a joke.
I almost killed myself, Julie.
Russell, you need to let go of that birthday because it's a long time ago.
It's just hard for me to accept chode jeans from Julie when your husband's loaded. I mean, you're not shy about that your husband's loaded, right? We've all seen him. He's a little bit older, doesn't look that good, right? I'm not saying anything you're not completely open about, right?
Yeah, I should have got up on that desk.
Yeah, you're right.
My husband is very good looking.
Julie!
Okay. First off, I want to thank all of you for helping us with this focus group for Sony Animation's new movie, Bamboo 2, Bamboozled. It's a sequel to Bamboo, which came out in 2009, before any of you were born. Now, you've just seen the first and final cut of the film. It's 84 minutes long. We'd love to get any reactions you have. First thoughts, there are no wrong answers. Yes?
The reason I like this movie is because it's my favorite movie of all time.
Interesting. Now, you said the same thing last weekend at the focus group for Minions 7 President Minions.
Minions 7 President Minions was my favorite movie, but that movie is nothing to me now. That is the past. I am a new woman.
You're all about Bamboo 2 now.
Yeah. Bamboo 2, Bamboozled, is my identity now. It's my Halloween costume, my birthday theme, my thermos. It will be my favorite...
Hold on, I'm writing this down.
Good. It will be my favorite movie forever.
Wow. Strong words. Raise your hands if this movie that you just saw, Bamboo 2, Bamboozled, is your favorite movie of all time. Okay, that's unanimous. And who among you thinks you might run home and tell the entire plot of the movie breathlessly to the first adult they see?
In the movie, the koala Kimmy has...
Yeah, I produced it, I know, but yeah.
Kimmy the koala has to go find her mojo, so she goes to the jungle, and then they fall in the mud, and at the end there's a song. Yeah. And but one part I forgot was when the kangaroo falls on its butt.
Could we use that entire thing as the logline to the movie?
You may.
All right. Let's talk about some of the characters. Sir.
Excuse me, the woman said I could leave at 5, but I can leave at 5:30.
That's great feedback. Thank you. Now, the studio spared no expense getting some very big names to voice the different, you know, animals or whatever. Who knows who did the voice of Benji the Cockatiel?
Mark Ruffalo!
That's right, Mark Ruffalo from You Can Count on Me, HBO's The Normal Heart. Would you raise your hands if knowing that Mark Ruffalo was doing the voice of the cockatiel enhanced your experience of the movie? That is unanimous. Okay. And who do we think did the voice of Kiki the boa constrictor?
Elizabeth Banks. At first, I was like, who is this? Is it Anna Kendrick? Is it Elizabeth Banks? And it was.
Wasn't Anna Kendrick Dottie the Dodo?
Very good, it was Anna Kendrick. But who knows who did the voice of her husband and or brother, Denny the Dodo?
It was definitely someone. And frankly, it was driving me crazy.
Okay, raise your hands if you could tell that the voice of Denny the Dodo was someone, but you couldn't quite place him. It was Jeremy Renner.
Oh! Oh, yeah, finally.
Now, the wise old wombat.
Mandy Patinkin.
Yes, Mandy Patinkin. How early did you know?
Immediately. As soon as he exhaled through his nose, I turned to the man next to me and said, that's our Mandy.
You were sitting next to a man you didn't know.
When I came back from the bathroom, I sat next to the wrong guy.
How many times did you go to the bathroom?
5. 4 productive.
Mm. One thing!
Yes?
My name's Isabella.
This is my favorite movie. I went to the bathroom 9 times.
I just want to tell you about what happens in this one scene of the movie.
Well, I produced it. I know all the scenes, but yeah.
All the lady emus are at the water, and then the song comes in.
Ah, the song Today is the Day by Ed Sheeran, written for this movie, but not in context.
The song comes in, and they like... And then they go...
Yeah. Yep. The scene where they dance around, yeah. They do dance around. Okay. Thank you so much for that. Now, when they're down at the river, Arnold the Wombat, absolutely as Dax Shepard, says something is fake news. Now, did any of you get that joke? No? Okay. Did anyone's parents laugh at that joke? Yeah, a light laugh?
An acknowledgement.
That's all it deserves. I can't thank you enough for this. I mean, you've given us your feedback, but more importantly, you've given us your time. Now, no one goes home empty-handed, so as you're leaving, some woman is gonna give you a backpack shaped like a koala that's fairly useless, and it is filled with tubes of yogurt. Yeah! Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you.
We here at Ford would like to thank you all for agreeing to be part of this focus group. Your ideas will actually be used in helping us create a brand new model. There are no wrong answers, so let's go around the room, and you just go ahead and call out features you'd love to see implemented in your ideal car, whenever you're ready.
Bluetooth capabilities?
Great.
Voice-activated lights?
Perfect.
Satellite radio?
Mm-hmm. Extra cup holders?
And a phone holder.
A good steering wheel that doesn't fly off while you're driving.
Rearview camera?
Comfy seats.
A good steering wheel that doesn't fly off your hand while you're driving.
Automatic side view mirrors.
A gray steering wheel that doesn't whiff out of the window while I'm driving. That is a good idea.
Yeah, I wrote it down.
Oh, nice.
Okay, what do we think it should look like?
Sleek.
Good.
High tech.
Aerodynamic.
Too small.
I'm sorry?
Too small. So when you get in there, you're like, is the steering wheel fly off? I'm toast.
Okay, I don't know why we'd make it too small.
I think it's a good idea, and I'm standing by.
Okay.
Maybe you could have like a sporty look.
Great.
Teach respect.
Any other ideas?
Stinky!
What?
What about if it is stinking inside?
Sorry, you want that in a car?
I'm sorry. I cannot think any good car idea because this guy keeps farting.
Okay, let's just try and focus on the car. What are some ways we can make it family-friendly?
No space for mother-in-law.
That's not helpful.
Shut up, Paul. You probably love your mother-in-law.
I actually do.
Oh, my God. He admitted it. Paul?
What?
Paul?
What?
You have the good car ideas.
Shut up.
I'm doing the best at this.
All right, maybe we should lay off Paul.
That's what his wife said.
Okay, this car is everything. You flinched, Paul. Now you have to marry your mother-in-law.
Yeah, because he landed it and you flinched. You have to marry your mother-in-law.
I did not flinch.
You flinched.
You have to
marry your mother-in-law.
I didn't flinch.
Come on, Paul.
If you don't, that means you yourself admitted yourself that you suck.
That's true. Well, you flinch from the bottle, Paul.
Who is the most popular now?
Paul, you have to marry your mother-in-law if you flinch at the bottle.